عبد رسول الله ما بعد. As you know, we agreed that we will read this kitab about what Imam Bukhari and Muslim agreed upon, the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We will read it, in Arabic on Saturday after Fajr. And inshallah, I will try to translate it for the English speakers, as we agreed, Sunday, Wednesday, and Friday. Okay? And we'll take inshallah minimum 5, maximum 10 minutes, between 5 to 10 minutes, because we have to read the hadith in Arabic and then translate in English. I will not go word by word, but I will try to translate the meaning, and most of the hadith you already know. Okay, so inshallah we'll start from today, and inshallah we'll try to keep this way. And the good thing that inshallah it's around 1600 hadith, which will take a long time. But this will be the chain connected to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم through the Sheikh who wrote the book, which is the Sheikh Abdul Muhsin bin Muhammad Qasim, and he's the Imam of the Masjid al-Nabawi, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم Holy Mosque in Medina. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. عن عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إنما الأعمال بالنية وإنما لكل امرئ وإنما لامرئ ما نوى فمن كانت هجرته إلى الله ورسوله فهجرته إلى الله ورسوله ومن كانت هجرته لدنيا يصيبها أو امرأة يتزوجها فهجرته إلى ما هاجر إليه. So عمر بن الخطاب narrated that Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that all the actions that we do based on the niyyah, your niyyah. Okay, and every person when he does anything, he will be rewarded or punished according to his niyyah, even if he doesn't do the work. Whoever his migration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger, so his niyyah that he would go to Allah will be for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger. And whoever his niyyah for any purpose of this life, like business or marriage or whatever, so his niyyah, he would be rewarded accordingly to his niyyah. And he mentioned that he's going to for dunya or a woman to marry, so his hijrah will be for the purpose he went for. Hadith number 2 عن عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت, this is a long one, so I will switch between Arabic and English during the hadith. So عائشة رضي الله عنها said, قالت كان أول ما بدأ به رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من الوحي الرؤيا الصادقة في النوم فكان لا يرى رؤيا إلا جاءت مثل فلق الصبح. The first revelation to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam started with the dreams, the good dream or the true dreams that he sees sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So every dream he sees, it will happen the following day or in few days, like the light of the day, which is like it is so true that you know it happens, so that the vision will happen. ثم حبب إليه الخلاء. And he loved to be alone, صلى الله عليه وسلم. فكان يخلو بغار حراء يتحنث فيه الليالي أولات العدد قبل أن يرجع إلى أهله ويتزود لذلك. So he used to go to the cave of Hira, and he would worship Allah سبحانه وتعالى inside the cave for many nights before he goes back to his family, like his wife, and bring food to go for a few days and come back. So every time he will come, bring food from Sham kitchen and go back to the cave. And then, ثم يرجع إلى خديجة فيتزود لمثلها. And then he go back to خديجة, our mother رضي الله عنها, and take extra food and so on. حتى فجأه الحق وهو في غار حراء. Until the haq, which is Jibreel عليه السلام, came to him in the cave. فجاءه الملك. The angel came to him. فقال اقرأ. He said read. فقال ما أنا بقارئ. I'm not a reader. I don't know how to read. قال فأخذني فغطني حتى بلغ مني الجهد ثم أرسلني. Like he hold me until like he squeezed me, you know. And I felt it's the stress or the pressure from him. And he let me go. فقال اقرأ. قلت ما أنا بقارئ. And he said again read. And he said I'm not a reader. I don't know how to read. فأخذني فغطني الثانية حتى بلغ مني الجهد ثم أرسلني. And he took me again second time, and he you know hold me too much until I felt the pressure, and he let me go. فقال أقرأ. فقلت ما أنا بقارئ. He said read, and I said again I don't know how to read. فأخذني فغطني الثالثة حتى بلغ مني الجهد. And he did the same for the third time, ثم أرسلني and let me go. فقال أقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق
اقرأ وربك خلق الإنسان من علق، اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم. ده بيجيني بسورة الايه؟ سورة العلق. read by the name of your رب، the one who created سبحانه وتعالى، the one who created the insan from the علق which is a phase of the creation inside the womb of the mother. And read and Allah سبحانه وتعالى is the generous one. Allah سبحانه وتعالى the one who taught by the pen، علم الإنسان ما لا يعلم، he taught the insan whatever he doesn't know. فرجع بها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ترجف بوادره حتى دخل على خديجة فقال زملوني زملوني، فزملوه حتى ذهب عنه الرب. صلى الله عليه وسلم went back to his house خديجة رضي الله عنها and he's so scared and he told خديجة cover me cover me and then so they covered him until he calmed down صلى الله عليه وسلم. ثم قال لخديجة أي خديجة مالي، and he told خديجة I don't know what happened to me، وأخبرها الخبر and he told her what happened with the angel جبريل. قال لقد خشيت على نفسي، like I was scared I feared what something wrong happened to me صلى الله عليه وسلم. قالت له خديجة and خديجة told him كلا أبشر no you have a good news فوالله لا يخزيك الله أبدا إنك والله إنك لتصل الرحم وتصدق الحديث وتحمل الكل وتكسب المعدوم أو تكسب المعدوم وتقري الضيف وتعين على نوائب الحق. So خديجة رضي الله عنها said that no by Allah Allah سبحانه وتعالى will not let you down. You connect the relationship with your relatives. يعني you are good to your relatives and you are saying the truth صلى الله عليه وسلم. And if someone needs help you help him. You carry his stuff. And if someone is poor you help him with money. And if you have a guest you give him enough food and good food. You are generous to the guests. وَتُعِينُوا عَلَى نَوَائِبِ الْحَقِّ. If someone has a calamity or a big disaster or problem, you go and support him. فانطلقت به خديجة حتى أتت به ورقة ابن نوفل ابن أسد ابن عبد العزة وهو ابن عم خديجة أخي أبيها. So she took him and she went to a man called ورقة ابن نوفل. He was the cousin of خديجة رضي الله عنها. وكان امرأة تنصر في الجاهلية and he used to be he became a Christian before the Islam time. وكان يكتب بالكتاب العربي and he used to يعني he knows how to write in Arabic because few people knows how to write or read at that time. ويكتب من الإنجيل بالعربية ما شاء الله أن يكتب and he used to translate the Bible from Hebrew or Aramaic language to Arabic. وكان شيخا كبيرا قد عمي. He was an old man and he became blind. فقالت له خديجة أي عم اسمع من ابن أخيك. Oh my uncle listen to your nephew. قال ورقة بن نوفل يا ابن أخي ماذا ترى. Oh my يعني son of my brother what happened to you. فأخبره رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خطر ما رأى. أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم told him what happened. فقال له ورقة هذا الناموس الذي أنزل على موسى صلى الله عليه وسلم يا ليتني فيها جذعة يا ليتني أكون حيا حين يخرج قومك. And he told him this is the revelation that came same revelation that came or same method that came to موسى عليه السلام and I wish if I'm strong with you to help you and support you and I wish if I'm alive when your people will kick you out of Mecca. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أو مخرجيهم they will let me out they will kick me out of Mecca. قال ورقة نعم yes لم يأتي رجل قط بما جئت به إلا أودي وإن يدركني يومك أنصرك نصرا مؤزرا. He said no one will came with what you came with which is the deen the حق from Allah سبحانه وتعالى the truth except his people will take him as an enemy. And if I live and I have the day that you became a prophet, I will support you like 100%. زاد البخاري في رواية. مم بخاري هذا an extra يعني narration that ثم لم ينشب ورقته أن توفي وفتر الوحي. And he said بخاري added that after a while ورقة passed away and the وحي stopped. Coming to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is the second hadith with the long one. We stop here, but this is where we're going to do inshallah. So every Aisha through the three days, inshallah we'll continue. JazakAllah khair.
السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. But quick announcement, because this is important. We will not explain the hadith. We just mention the hadith in Arabic and translate. Okay? The explanation of the hadith is a different story. Note number two. Don't take a rule from the hadith, like especially fiqh rule. Okay? Because some hadith was cancelled. The Prophet ﷺ will do something, and after a while he will the wahi from Allah Subhanahu wa Taala to do something else. So very important when you read even Riyad al-Salihin, when you go for Jawla, you see a hadith. No, when you take any fiqh issue, you have to take it from books of fiqh, not books of hadith. Because any issue, we have to see all the ayat, all the verses from the Quran, all the hadith, and the last verses. Okay, and as you know, لا تقربوا الصلاة وأنتم سكارى. Don't come to prayer while you are drunk. So someone will say, you know, okay, I will drink, you know, like after Isha, and I will come in Fajr, you know, 100%. I know that. No, this ayah was concealed, like it's cancelled with إنما الخمر والميسر والأنصاب والأزلام رجس من عمل الشيطان فاجتنبوا. Avoid it completely. Okay, the hadith is the same. جزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
كيف حالك يا حبيبي؟